so that we can mitigate the effects of the drought, which is as a result of climate change and other factors. In a nutshell, there are several strategies that we have come up with, and one of them is that there has been a lack of coordination between the national government, the county government, and our development partners, resorting to communication of the various interventions. We have agreed that county steering teams are constituted and made operational. That will be chaired jointly by the governors and the county commissioners, and all the state and non-state actors will be members. And all this is why we go to the humanitarian intervention with members of the community. Because of the urgency of the required interventions, those committees have been convened for Tuesday in all the affected counties under the chairmanship of the governors, with the help of the county commissioners, to appraise the situation and identify the needs and the interventions that are so required, and come back to the National Secretariat, that is domiciled here in my office, for intervention and supply of food. We want to thank our governors who are here, from their side, to partner with the national government and our development partners as a part of the mitigation strategy to help the people of Kenya who have been affected by the drought. We have agreed that all water agencies across the country have mobilized 100 water buses that will be deployed in all the areas that have been badly affected to assist in getting water to human beings and livestock so that we can address the water shortage that is prevalent in those areas. Again, Kenya Defense Forces have agreed to provide water rigs to engage in an emergency drilling exercise to drill as many boreholes as practically possible in various parts of the country. Again, the Ministry of Water has given a proposal that we are discussing with Treasury on how we can obtain more water tanks and also contribute in drilling more boreholes in the areas that are required. To enhance transparency and accountability, all food by the national government, by the county government, by our development partners will be received and distributed by the county coordinating teams. And all that food will be documented from the point of being received up to the distribution. We have also agreed with the county governors for transparency and accountability. All food purchased by the county government will be surrendered to the coordinating teams so that all players are well appraised on what has been provided and in the manner in which it is distributed. Finally, we want to appeal to our development partners and the international community to consider giving us more resources so that we can offer what the national government has put in place, in addition to what the county governments will be able to put in place, so that we can mitigate the crisis. Again, in terms of livestock intervention, we know to a lot of concern the destruction of livelihoods, livestock herders who have lost livestock become impoverished, and their lives almost come to a halt. As a part of the mitigation, we have agreed with the Kenya Meat Commission and the Kenya Red Cross within the ambit of the county coordinating teams that we shall purchase livestock for slaughtering and distribution to the needy population for feeding, and at the same time we prepare corned beef for distribution to the schools so that our children are able to go to school without failure. In a nutshell, we want to assure the people of Kenya that our government, county governments and our development partners are well coordinated. We have agreed that we must make enough interventions to ensure that no Kenyan will die as a result of this commission. I want to thank President William Ruto for being very proactive in this matter. This meeting has been convened at his request, and he has directed that every 10 days we meet so that we can appraise the situation of the necessary information and keep him informed. For the purposes of the media and the Kenyan people to know what is happening, we have agreed and we have requested request Kenya Defense Forces to assist us to set up a command center in this office that will regularly brief the media and the people of Kenya on the interventions that are being made and the prostitution in general, so that we all go in the same direction. And this being a public matter, the public and the press is entitled to information on a weekly basis. So those few remarks, I want to say thank you.